Hey guys, my name is Dion. In this video, we're going to be doing a detailed review and taking a look at Surfshark for Mac. But first, why get a VPN? A VPN is a service that protects your internet connectivity and privacy online by creating an encrypted tunnel for your data and hiding your IP address. VPNs also allow you to bypass internet restrictions and access content that is otherwise only available in specific countries. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Surfshark. Now, Surfshark is a VPN that is best known for its value proposition, providing many features for a very compelling price. If you're interested in Surfshark, I will leave links to the best possible deals in the description. Surfshark has over 3,200 servers in 65 countries all over the world, and is supported on all major desktop as well as mobile operating systems, even supporting browser extensions and smart TVs. One of the best features of Surfshark is the ability to connect an unlimited number of devices to your account. This is especially impressive when compared to the 5 to 6 device limits found on NordVPN or ExpressVPN. This ensures that all of your devices will be connected under a single Surfshark account. Before I go into the features and tests, I want to take a look at the user interface. Unlike, for example, NordVPN, which can run in a window as well as the menu bar, Surfshark exclusively runs in the menu bar. This is good because the compact and minimalistic user interface is very easy to access whilst using other apps, as this does not take up a window. On the other hand, since the interface is so small and compact, there are a lot of menus and submenus. Thankfully though, these are organized in a relatively logical way. Overall, the interface is clean and generally easy to navigate. One thing I particularly like in the app is Surfshark has added a link that directs you straight to its list of helpful resources and guides on their website. This is especially great for new users. But how well does Surfshark perform? Now, I've run several tests comparing different locations and have used as many of the same locations as possible from previous tests to make it easy to compare the data. Let's take a look. First is the baseline with no VPN. You can see I average around 60 megabytes of download speed and 5.4 megabytes of upload speed. Using Quick Connect, where Surfshark finds what it believes to be the best server based on my location, you can see the speeds are largely retained, seeing only a slight drop in speed. Taking a look at Sweden and Israel, we see very similar results. Further down in the US, I've connected to both East and West Coast and have found the numbers to be quite consistent and stable. This theme continues throughout Asia, where again we see no significant drop in performance. Of course, there are many factors that can affect these results, but this should give you an idea of how well Surfshark performs across different regions. Now, if speed is your number one priority, I do suggest looking at NordVPN. Although a little bit more expensive, I found it to perform very fast, performing close to baseline. That said, rest assured, with Surfshark, you get good and stable performance. Overall, seeing just about a 9% change in download speeds and a 4% change in upload speeds. In practice, I can tell you this difference is very hard to notice, particularly in download speeds. I also want to point out that switching between servers and countries is exceptionally fast and seamless. Surfshark is very capable of streaming. It unblocks many common streaming services such as Disney+, Hulu, and HBO Now. Additionally, Surfshark can access Netflix libraries from all over the world, including the US, UK, Japan, South Korea, and India. In terms of torrenting, this is very much possible. Surfshark offers a wide range of P2P servers across the globe that support it and all major P2P clients. This is made extra secure by the integrated kill switch as well as the no logs policy, but more on that later. When it comes to VPNs, privacy is key. So how does Surfshark perform in this area? Surfshark performs very well here for its strong AES 256 encryption. When you're connected, Surfshark has other ways to even further protect your privacy through different protocols and specialty servers. This includes support for all registry standard protocols such as IPv2, OpenVPN, UDP, and TCP, as well as WireGuard. Additionally, Surfshark also features static IP, also known as dedicated IP, which will give you one consistent IP. This is useful when using apps such as online banking, where logging in from different IPs and different countries can create login issues. Multihop, also known as double VPN, will connect you through two servers, making your already secure connection even more secure. Camouflage mode is automatically enabled when using OpenVPN, UDP, or TCP protocols, allowing you to bypass internet restrictions. In essence, this makes your connectivity look like regular internet connectivity from the outside by removing any traces of a VPN. Additionally, Surfshark offers CleanWeb. which will automatically block certain pop-ups as well as ad trackers. No borders mode allows you to bypass internet restrictions. It is great to see this feature included and will also automatically activate if Surfshark detects any kind of restrictions on your network. Finally, Surfshark uses RAM-only servers. This allows for even more privacy, as when they are turned off, the servers are completely wiped. And this brings us to security. One of Surfshark's key features in this area is an integrated kill switch. A kill switch is there to prevent any data leaks in the event that the VPN connection drops. This is a feature I definitely suggest you activate. Now, an area for Surfshark to build on this feature would be to add, alongside the general kill switch, an app-specific kill switch that is seen in some of its competitors. Importantly, Surfshark also claims to have a strict no logs policy, in which Surfshark states that they will not collect details such as your IP address, browsing history, session information, used bandwidth, and connection timestamps. Furthermore, Surfshark backs up these claims through an independent audit performed in 2018. Even though the scope of the audit, only looking at browser extensions, was not as wide or recent as, for example, the audits done by NordVPN, it is still reassuring to know that these reports have been made and shared. This gives Surfshark actual evidence to support its no-logging claims. In terms of customer support, I was impressed by its expansive list of online resources found on their website. You can also sort articles by category and search by keyword. There is even a range of video tutorials which are easy to follow. Finally, Surfshark also has a 24/7 live chat. In my experience, this worked very well, connecting me with an agent in a matter of seconds to help solve the issue. Now that we've looked at the key features of Surfshark, let's take a look at the plans. Surfshark offers a range of plans at different price points, depending on the length of the plan you choose, ranging from 1 to 24 months. The 24-month plan gives you by far the best value, but again, I will leave links to the best possible offers for Surfshark in the description. At the end of the day, I can highly recommend Surfshark. It offers a strong list of features, has a compact and minimalist user interface, is secure, and allows you to connect an unlimited number of devices. All of this for a very compelling price. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section, and if this video helped you out, be sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.